Well, the shepherds was really a band of children whose parents were more or less popular musicians in Jamaica, or popular reggae musicians, I should say, you know what I mean? So it consisted of myself, Shia Core, who's here with us now, and his father is Cat Core from Third World. And then we had Shima Beth McGregor, who her parents are Judy Mowat, who was in the I3s, who used to sing with my father, and Freddie McGregor, who's another popular, pardon me, reggae artist. So basically that was what the concept of the group was, and we didn't really do any recording of our own, we more performed like a cover band. So the group was completely, you know, separated now, everyone has gone their own way in that sense. Shia is here with us now, like I said, playing bass. But that is the extent of making music as the Shepherds, me and him.
Now, I had to listen to that album, which is beautiful, and it's quite honest and irreverent, but it's still very commercially successful. So how much planning went in to get the album and get this mixture right of still having your lyrics honest, but having a commercial mix that people could really relate to?
27 years of planning. You know what I mean? Really, it wasn't a plan. You know, really, we make music and we just make the music that we love. It's not a premeditated thing like we're trying to break down the message in a commercial form. No, it's just, you know, we make music and this is the music that we love to make, and of course we express what is our true feelings. So what you hear the lyrics are saying is just how I feel about situations. And like I said, the music, the beats, whatever, it's just the music that we like.
So with this album, with the making of Welcome to Jamrock, were you aiming at a crossover audience the way that your father did with Catch a Fire?
Yeah, I mean, aiming at an audience, really. Not even just a crossover audience, just aiming at an audience, you know? I am a fan of urban music, love urban music, hip-hop music, dancehall music. So of course, you know, I want to make the music that I'm a fan of, you know, and reach the people who are from that base also. But like I said again, when making music, we don't really premeditate it too much or try to get too conscious about what we're doing. We just kind of make the energy or the vibe of the moment take us where it's taking us.
What impact has making the album with your family had on the album for you?
Well, that's kind of hard to say, you know, that's really the only way that I've ever made music, you know what I mean? So it's, for me, it's just a natural thing, you know what I mean? And that's how we operate. I don't really know of operating any other way.
Do you feel the weight of your father's legacy on your shoulders in that way?
Actually, I feel my father's legacy underneath my feet lifting me up to make me taller, rather than on my shoulders putting me down. So I'm more standing on his shoulders.
Yeah. We'll have a fantastic night tonight, Damien. Thank you so much for meeting with us, and we'll see you at the gig later.
Yes.
Cool.